Welcome to Harburn Double Low, or indeed welcome back to Harburn Double Low. This is my introduction to the Pi Pico, or the what you better call the Pi Pico W, or even the Pi Cow, used with Rockrail via the WIO system in Rockrail, wireless input output system. It's really the next step in technology. I think it's really more advanced. Back in my days in the 1970s, for example, you're quite happy to have a train running around the layout. Now the technology is really getting there to be quite advanced, but as advanced as you want it to be. First of all, I've got a couple of thank yous to say for the help me out with this project. The first one is to a YouTube channel called 88K Model Railroads. This chap, very little numbers he's got in his subscriptions. Please help him out, subscribe to him. He's really quite knowledgeable on the subject. And indeed, I'll leave a link down below for his channel, linking to how to set up the WIO Peak Pico onto your system. The next thanks goes to Rob Rockrail Wikipedia. Yesterday I spent a fair bit of time dialogue with the forum, getting some information off Rob. And as always there, the forum is a place to go if you've got any questions on the WIO, as Rob is quite knowledgeable and there are quite a few guys out there to help you as well. So let's start off with a little demonstration of where I am so far with it. Not too advanced with it, just a simple LEDs and a little servo running so far, but let's fire up and let you see it. So, I first go into the WIO. I'm going to query it, and once you initialise the WIO, the little LED light starts to flash. So it's now recognised it's here. I've called it the ID 39, it's under the name Loco. It's version 7.5.2, and all the type you can get with the Pi Cow is IO. Battery 61%, we'll come back to that just shortly. And the other bits is where it's plugged into the IP. This got the IP address of 192.16.1.20. And the manufacturer's Pico. So okay that. I go back to the main hub here. I've put this one to Harburn's double O rather than a blank one, just to let you see how it demonstrates. So on here I've got three outputs. The outputs lead to these LEDs. I've got red, yellow and green. So just a matter of switching each one on. Red on, yellow on, green on, and of course they go back off as well, just as a set as an output. And I will go back into a little more detail just shortly how I use this. So for the outputs, I go into properties. It is ID, there's an ID number here. The number is number 1 and the decoder is set to WIO39. We'll go into the interface. The interface is WI0 and the node is 39. The address for this one here is number 1. Now you've got addresses for the outputs, inputs from 1 to 16. So this corresponds, this red line, to GP10 on the Pico itself. Pico in their wisdom did print the labels on the bottom side so you can't see. That's why I've got this breakout board here. And the rest is just a matter of the value 1 or 0. Now down here I've got it set to LED. That's for the LEDs itself. No other thing, nothing other than that, apart from setting that up. I will go back and show you briefly how to set up the Pico. But as I'm saying, if you go to 88K Model Railroad, he's got a fantastic tutorial on setting up the Pico. So okay that. Next I've got a switch, a turnout in the UK as we call them. This is set up with the servo here. I'll take the cable away, let you see it. If I switch it across, the servo moves, moving the point. I switch it back again. It's got a little glitch there, that's just because of how I've set the power up. I haven't disabled the 3 volts on the board yet. You can get a separate board from Rockwell, I'll show you just shortly. So it's just a little glitch here. Once I sort the power out, that glitch hopefully should go. So let's see how I set the servo up in Rockwell. If I go down to my tables and go to my switches, switch number 9, WIO, in the general tab, it's got the ID, nothing much in there to change apart from the interface. Now in the interface there, you've got the interface ID is WIO. I've only got a choice in this one here between that and the ECOS, my main one itself. The node ID is number 39, that is because it's set up on WIO number 39. Do not set it to 33. If you set it to 33, that's the default and you can't add any more, so always change it to something different. You can go to 34, but for me I went to 39 for reasons. The protocol was default. Now this is where it becomes interesting. The WIO can take up to 4 servos. So the number of servos you want in here is the address you want. This servo, let's take it back to here, is connected via a 270 ohm resistor into GP6, which is address number 1 for servos. Don't get that confused with address number 1 for the red LED. Next we have the parameters. The parameters is how much you want the servo to move. Across here I've set to 90 and the bottom value to 1. You can click on here and you can set them to fine adjust where you want them yourself. So OK that. Next down we go to the switch time, 3 milliseconds. This is not really the switch time as in such, but it's the speed, how fast the servo moves. For example, if I take that up to 8 milliseconds, OK it and press the switch, you see it moves a lot faster. So back into properties. And interface. So that's just your speed. So the address 1 is the servo 1, 1 being GP6, 2 being GP7, 3 being GP8, and number 4 being GP9 on the Pico. So again, don't get them confused with the WIO addresses 16 for your outputs, inputs. If you want to see how to set up sensors as a input, go and see 88K Railroad. He has a fantastic tutorial on how to set up sensors, which is a little bit easier than set up the servo, I should say. So down the bottom, the type has got to be set to servo. So let's go and do a brief overview on the setting up of the Pico. When you first set it up, you scan devices there. It picks up where it is on your USB device. You're not sure, you can go to My Devices, etc. You then click Connect. It'll go through the connection system and then you start to program it in. In here, you scan for your Wi-Fi system, you put in your password and you keep it to AP2, AP1 I should say. Then the part where I fell down quite a lot there was a servo name. Now in here you put down the IP address of this laptop PC you're currently using to wire the device into. And the ID number, you call it what you want, and then you save it. In here as well, the double IO there, you can set them to whatever you want. O being output, I being input, and B for block direct detection. But the same again, we'll show you just shortly a bit more detail. Now, on the main board here, the query board there, with your WIO, don't get confused with the servos and LEDs there. When you set the PyCode, first off, there's only one option there, and it's IO016. So once you go into the fine details of the outputs and inputs, that's where you can specify it in the settings for each of your outputs or switches. Or indeed, if you're clever, you can start to use the display screens as well, so you can put up your station announcements. That's work in the future, folks. So in there, in my setup, let's see, I for input, O for output, P for pulse, and B for block detection if you're using the sensors. The rest of it over here, if you've got to set up your display screens, you can put up what size of board you want and so on with it. Not a really great deal for me at the moment there. I haven't done much experimenting on this side as such. You can also update it as well. If you want to update your chip, you can do it through here, and you can do it over the air rather than be plugged in to the PC. Now, if we go to the wiki RockRail, in the RockRail wiki, you've got your WIO16. You go in here and you can see these boards here. You've got the PCB board and you've got the PyCow W board with the PyCow plugged into it. It's a little board here. If I put this schematic just there now, so this is the scary part for most people, these drawings, the schematic drawings here. So in this part here, you've got your chip, your PyCow. Down here, you've got pins going out to your GPIO16 pins here. There's actually 20 pins there because one is for ground and one is for voltage on each bank. This part here is just a voltage regulator. The same again, I've not got that fit into my system yet. That's why I think you know a little glitch on the turning of the servo. I have got one of these voltage regulators. I bought one about 7 years ago. They're not cheap. They're about £4 to £5, being £7 sometimes. I bought mine a few years ago, and for the life of me, I can't find it. Then up this part here, you've got your servo outputs, then you've got your IC2 outputs as well. This is for your screen, so your SD and your SCL as well. Now, at the time of filming this today, I looked on to buy these boards from RockRail, but at the moment I can't see them up for sale. I could be wrong there, folks. If you go to the order sheet and the order form here, you've got your product there. You've got WIPI, which I do not think it is the one I want, because there's several boards out there, folks. Hopefully I'm going to drop an email to Rob via the wiki forum, and hopefully be able to buy a board in just shortly to build up for these folks. Now, you can buy the boards pre-built, or you can buy the kit, or you can just buy the board and supply the chips, resistors, yourself. That's us for now, folks. The world out there is our oyster, as I say. I do have a bag of sensors. These are just one of the bags you buy off of eBay. I think it was £11.50 for all these sensors here. And two or three of them, like say this one here, you can use for your inputs for your sensors on the railway, i.e. it's a little light sensor. The train goes on the top of it, pulls a signal. Now you need to tie in this with a pull-up resistor, 10k resistor, same again, go to 88k model railroad. He'll show you the perfect way to set up these things here. So that's us for the now, folks. A bit different, going back to the electronics, going back to the scary stuff with wire and circuit diagrams, but that's been a learning curve myself for last week. I've really enjoyed it. One more thanks is to Peter Bradbear, because Peter Bradbear done a demonstration with the Arduinos, and he mentioned this Pi Pico chip as well during his demonstration, and lo and behold, I fell in a trap and bought some. I've got two of these ones here, and I've also got two of the ones without the Wi-Fi system on top of it. So, it is work in progress, folks. Please like, subscribe, any comments, anything you want to see using the Pi Pico, drop me a wee note. Then again, I'm not the total expert. If you want expert advice there, please do go to the wiki and the forum for Rockrail, and their guys are the experts. Thanks for watching, folks. Bye.